Hello?
Hey, boo.
Hey, baby.
How are you?
How you doing?
Hey.
So, what are you wearing?
Not bad. Better than what am I wearing? Wearing a stretched out Star Wars shirt and work jeans.
Oh, you didn't have to dress up for me. That's real sweet.
I got underwear on that hasn't waistband in 6 months. Are you wet yet, James?
Sploosh. Am I right? Yeah.
Oh, don't say sploosh.
How's it going?
Not bad. Better than last week, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Still not great. So we should have recorded last week to have our very special wrestling episode. My back was apparently broken.
Yeah. Well,
I just blew you off.
I want to preface that by saying that when we did go to the wrestling show, so we went to ECPW : Hudson Valley. I don't know if that's the correct denomination, but in any case, yeah, East Coast Professional Wrestling, the Hudson Valley unit or whatever. And you showed up with like hot water bottles and stuff, like you're in a cartoon.
Yeah, ice packs.
Yeah, like you're one step away from being like in those like old Looney Tunes cartoons with the Saint Bernard bringing you like a thing of brandy around its neck. Like, because you did something to fuck up your back. So, yeah, that
was not in good shape.
But what? So you're better now? What's going on?
On a Saturday, I believe.
Yeah. That was on a Saturday. So are you better? What's going on over there?
I'm a little better. I'm not at 100%, but so the next day I went and saw Thor, and like I was a wreck that day. Like in the comfiest friggin' chairs in the world, I could not get comfortable and not pain. So the morning, like we went at 10:15 in the morning because Jack had a show at noon that we were a little late for.
plus not nothing. That's matinee tickets, man. That's better than I paid $32 to go and see the movie with me and Monica. So it's movies are fucking stupid expensive.
$20 for 3D tickets, two 3D tickets, bro. $20, 10:15 a.m. Yeah. On Sunday. That's what that gets you.
Yes, it does.
But like, I woke up in bad shape. It was just in terrifying friggin' pain. And I took two muscle relaxers because one doesn't really do anything. And so we get to the movie and like 20 minutes, half an hour, and I'm like, all right, I'm not feeling great, but like I'm feeling better than when I got out of bed. And, you know, I'm not sleepy or anything, but like half an hour in, I start getting real sleepy. But I'm fighting it like crazy. And I make it to the Hulk fight, and I'm like, awesome. And then the second the Hulk fight ends, like another scene starts, and then like I blink and come into like these 10 lines of dialogue into the scene. I'm like, whoa, wait, what happened? Why is Hulk naked? And then next time, so you're gonna need to fill in a couple of bubbles for me, buddy.
Yeah, so that was after the Jeff Goldblum sex party. So you missed that scene?
I missed that. Was the only thing I wanted to see. Got in 3D too?
Yeah, you would have seen all the everything flying right at you. It would have been crazy.
That is one big pile of dick.
let's review that for a second. So we went to the ECPW HV show, which is the worst fucking name since BVS DOJ, but we
right off the bat had the time of my life.
Yes. Yes. I want to say that like, we're going to poke fun at this thing because it's what we do when we just do that to our betters, but had so much fun. Like, I had a headache at the end of the night, but not because of the weird hot dogs or anything that was going on there, but because I was laughing so fucking hard at everything that was going on. The show was so good and so interactive because we were like 10 feet away from everybody. So when you insult a professional wrestler and he's 10 feet away from you, he could personally look at you and go, "Hey, fuck you," and that's basically
Which
what happened.
Did.
Repeatedly,
numerous times.
Repeatedly, yeah. So we got one of the highlights, and right off the bat was the second match. This big dude comes out who was not in the best of shape, but he looks at you and me and are.
Is that a euphemism?
I'm not sure what's going on.
Okay, Bob and Neil.
I'm Brian, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
Bob and Neil, you guys were in the bathroom before.
Oh, don't ruin my proposal. We're getting married. It's legal now.
You can't talk to him that way. A respectable man.
He's got a tie
boo.
On.
Oh, you are a bad guy. Boo. Hey, boo.
Just to make sure we all understand. The guy in the ring.
A rice joke. You're a monster.
All right,
all right. The guy called us gay.
He did. Oh, yeah. We're not gay!
Don't play with the little kids down there, okay, you
pervert?
What? What just happened?
Oh, man.
Just, wow. Yeah, really.
Did you just insult a teenage boy? Yeah. Call him a pervert?
Strike the hammer.
Boom! Get out of here, the grimace.
Wait a minute.
He's
dead.
I wasn't expecting
that. That was really insensitive of him.
Which, insensitive is a theme that was going to come back over and over again. As that
really did.
Yeah, as that guy fought a mental patient, there was a guy coming out trying to be a bad guy, talking about how great Canada is, which was tough to take him seriously because everyone kind of likes Canada.
Oh, he's Canadian! Right,
yeah, Canada!
I love maple syrup, man.
I was born in Texas, woo! But Canada's pretty bad.
Canadians are so polite.
Canada!
Welcome from America's hat.
This dude is literally carrying a hockey stick.
But Canadians are always so polite. What is this guy's deal?
Tim Hortons! Yeah, Tim Hortons! Tim Hortons!
Woo!
What's up?
Woo!
What's up? We love Canada. You're not really being that threatening. I mean, Canada's great.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of your health insurance.
What you think? You're in the presence of greatness!
Yeah!
What's up, man?
I believe you!
I know. Don't you love Trudeau?
Good, you know.
I was freaking amazing.
Pick a more threatening country. Like, come out from North Korea or something. Yeah. You know, like, come out with something we're actually afraid of. We don't know a whole lot about North Korea, okay? It would have just worked. Yeah, I mean, look, right now I'd rather move to Canada. So, I mean, yeah. Yeah, I mean, have you seen our president? You're pretty okay, dude.
Canada!
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah, that kid's intense. Mad. Yeah.
And now for joining for this maple syrup match. Is,
oh, God. Oh,
is Aunt Jemima.
Oh,
no. Oh,
man. I might have to leave for a little bit. I don't know if I'm going to be a part of the Aunt Jemima syrup match.
Didn't he fight, like, a prisoner, too?
Yeah. He fought a prisoner who was a guy that, like, escaped. You know, his bit was he escaped from prison. And,
Yeah. So you're the bad guy. Stop trying to pretend you're the bad guy, Canada.
Yeah, it was...
And everybody booed Canada. They loved prisoner. They kept chanting USA, USA. It's... Like, you don't know where the prisoner is from.
No, he's from New Jersey, okay? We all knew he was
a bad
guy. Oh, that's
right, he was from Jersey.
Yeah.
Hailing from New Jersey.
He was definitely the bad guy. Let's not put on any airs here, guys, all right? We knew what he did wrong. There were little kids in, like, the next section over from us that got, like, really fucking into it. So, like, every bad guy that came out, they were, like, flipping them off. They were doing the suck it gesture. They were, like, nonstop about this stuff. And it's like, the guy would get up and leave. And then they would, like, chase this guy out into the locker room to be like, yeah, and the horse you rode in on, motherfucker. Like,
the announcer had to turn them back to their seats at one point. And then, like, they just kept doing it, and everybody was like, screw it. We're, like, I'm not chasing after these kids all night.
Whatever. If one of them takes an elbow to the face, he probably deserved it.
Yeah. I elbowed Esme in the face at Toys R Us today.
Was that why you were at Toys R Us? Just like, please, I'm sorry. Just, here's a toy.
I just wanted to do it in a public place. We drove to Toys R Us so I could elbow her in the face.
There you go. At least you have your priorities, I guess.
She was behind me by like a foot and walked into my elbow and then looked up at me and was like, how could you do this to me, Papa?
Like she felt betrayed. Like, why are you walking there? That's fucked up.
Bastard. Yeah.
What else do we do? So my brother came with us and he bought a hot dog, and then they were like, do you want any, we got some mate soaked in beer. Do you want those? And he was like really confused. He was like, wait, what? No.
It's a confusing thing to say.
He's like, just a regular hot dog, please. And then it was followed up by some other strange man who I'm not sure worked with the concession stand, but goes, hey, they tell you they got sauerkraut? We got sauerkraut here. And it was like,
why is some dude in the audience pushing the sauerkraut?
It was really strange because it's like, who are you? Where did you come from? Where is the sauerkraut? Because, like, do you have it, like, you're going to, like, open your jacket and there's just, like, a bunch of kraut hanging from your
I'm a little mad because no one told me any of the options. It was just a sign of hot dogs. And I was like, I'll take two hot dogs. They didn't tell me about the kraut. Not that I would want, like, a limp, wet hot dog that smells like Coors Light, but they didn't tell me that was an option.
Like, maybe.
I don't know what your brother's got going on. It's special.
Maybe it was like, oh, this guy's had enough. I mean, look at him with his hot water bags. I mean, he just came back from a bender. We don't need to give him any more.
The weight of the sauerkraut might kill him.
Yeah, I mean, look at him. I mean, you give him a beer-battered hot dog, he's going to be in that ring next.
I wanted to get in there so many times.
when the kids were running around in the ring, jumping all over the fucking place, yeah.
Especially, yeah, during intermission, like, they let all the kids play in the ring, and we walked back in, and we were like, oh, shit, the kids are going to fight each other.
Yeah, a 20-kid battle royale, like, yeah, that would watch that.
Yeah.
It would be just as impressive as some of the other things we've seen. So
I would watch it forever.
Yeah.
Like their acting game wasn't great, but but I do want to watch a bunch of kids try to powerbomb each other.
One of the other highlights, I think, was that one guy, look at me, was, so he, I forgot his name, Sensational, like Ricky or something like that.
But, oh yeah. Everybody had just names.
Yeah.
Like, there were two Andrews back to back.
Oh,
like,
yeah, the first
two matches, there were two Andrews.
Yes, but the first match, Andrew, or Andy, fought Timothy Plasma. And it was like, oh, like, why don't you just call yourself Plasma? Because Timothy in the front makes it a lot less intimidating, because you come out looking like Dracula.
Oh, yeah, he was the vampire, the first match was the vampire.
Yeah, remember
he bit Andy's neck a couple of times?
Yeah, he did. And he, like, hung upside down in the ring when he got there. Like, just in case you didn't know, I watched 1989's Batman the other day. The shit was cool
as
shit.
That's what we said. I want to hear the audio.
Yes, I know. So this guy, though, the Sensational Bobby or whatever his name was, he has on his trunks... Look at me, and it was like there were a couple of, like, based on where we were seeing in terms of eye level to the ring, was like, oh, that's a close up I didn't entirely need right now, but
yeah, it was like mad tight underwear, yeah. like real tight speedos.
This guy like struck up a chord with you specifically because, like, you took a shining to him after he insulted you at one point of like when he came by and you were like, he went like, what'd you say? Because, again, they can hear everything we're saying. We're that close to them that they could hear everything.
I said we are the similar body type.
In your dreams, bro.
You got him, Kyle. I'm on your side now. Let's go.
It's like, hold up, fella. Your tits are slightly bigger than mine. Like,
but, like,
I'm okay with my body.
You started rooting for him and, like, doing chants that no one else wanted to participate in.
Nobody liked this guy except me.
Not a soul. But at one point, so his whole like persona was like, yeah, everyone loves me. You know, like I'm God's gift to all of you. And he stopped it, like, you know, he beat up the other guy. He gets up on like the turnbuckles or whatever, turns to
the
ground.
He was good too. He was athletically.
He was good. He did some flips and stuff. It was like really good stuff. But listen, he gets up on the turnbuckles and he looks at the crowd and goes, "I love all of you." And he turns to BJ, he turns to you, and goes, "And especially you."
I like the match was pretty. His match is pretty long and like real fast into it. I started to love the guy, and I kept chanting, "Look at me, look at me." And nobody was getting into it. I was the only guy rooting for him.
Yep. So you got
it. That guy.
No, that guy was pretty cool. It was a good show too.
I was booing him too first. We were all booing him first.
Well, we were confused as to who we were supposed to boo and who we were not supposed to boo at first.
Because, for the majority of the night, yeah. I think, right?
Because like people would come in, and you're like, "Are you a good guy? Like you look okay, but like, are you a good guy? Like the guy that Look at Me fought."
That's just because we've never been.
Yeah, but the guy that Look at Me fought comes out in like a mask and looking like a Ren Faire like anime hybrid, and we're like, I don't know, I can't see his eyes. Is he a good guy or a bad guy?
No, he didn't have a mask. He just had long hair and Ren clothes.
When he came in, he was wearing a mask.
I didn't remember.
His like
remember
ring
that.
Attire was like, what is this? Like, what's going on over here? What does this guy got going on?
He was dressed like a pauper, so yes. I just assumed he was the good guy. Like, I assume I'm the good guy because I'm a pauper.
Yeah. Carve out, I mean, I know we're missing, like, a match. Oh, the old guy match was really sad.
I was just going to bring that up. Like, the whole night was awesome.
Yeah.
And then got totally derailed by someone who was in the WWE mad long ago.
Yeah, so
Greg, if any listeners out there recognize the name Greg the Hammer Valentine, he wrestled in a church in Middletown last week.
It was
the saddest damn match I've ever seen.
He looked confused.
I was prefaced by the guy who was wrestling him. He was the guy who was wrestling him was clearly the heel because he came out just mad at everybody.
Yeah, he was.
And like really zeroed in on me, called me fat boy a bunch. And this was after intermission where like the wrestlers really seemed to zero in on me after.
Yeah. I think word started to spread.
Was like, they were all telling them about, there's this one guy. This fat piece of shit.
Yeah, because it was like
too many of the beer hot dogs and can't hold the hot dogs.
It was like, seriously, every other match was like, they just immediately were like, took the wind out of your sails. Like, before you could, like, drum up your vitriol or whatever, they're like, "Hey, fat boy." You're like, what did I do? Like, I didn't even say anything yet.
This guy's just mean. Turn it up. Turn this guy up. Loves metal, all right? Let's throw up the horns, guys. Oh, he wants the music louder, sir. He can't hear it.
That kid's just hammering the value.
Looks like
Did he threaten that old lady?
I think he did. He was like, "Yeah, I'm gonna fight
fuck
that old
you,
lady.
Mom,
next.
I'm gonna put you in an arm bar." Thanks for coming.
Thank you. Yeah, I'll sign your autograph later. Yeah.
Dad's still not talking to me.
Yeah, but like, that...
No. Oh,
that's gonna be an awkward Christmas. That's gonna be an awkward Christmas later when they. What's up, man?
Oh, I don't want no trouble. You don't like me already? I'm sorry. Behind your back, though, I'm gonna stop.
I'm good. He's from Sunset Beach.
He's from Hawaii.
Yeah. It's really tan, though. Like,
yeah,
he
right?
He probably has skin cancer.
Right? Oh, probably nothing. That guy is just one giant walking melanoma.
He's just a big mole. Like that he already knew, like, this guy's an asshole.
Yeah.
I'm going to come in and yell at him.
I thought I was being a good audience member. I'm sorry.
Not.
He
Metal socks.
He's wearing a diaper. Yes, yes. It does look like he's wearing a diaper. It's like. Made a echo boom boom. Is that the lady or the music? Because I
don't know.
Ripping his hair out? What's he doing? I don't know. He's a maniac, remember? That's the bit for half of these people. And this guy's like, this kid is like, I bought your t-shirt! But I thought we were friends!
I thought we were friends. What happened? Did I miss something?
Yeah, and now we're in a Sabbath concert, so. Yeah. Okay.
Turn this megaphone up, Danny.
I think you're good.
Yeah, you're peaking. Your levels are peaking. I mean, I'm not.
Just turn it up.
He
just said that.
He did.
And, hey, lady, somebody else beside me told you to shut up today, so shut up. You know, I was going to come out here and say how happy I was to be here. I sold a couple t-shirts, painted a couple of nice kids' faces.
Oh, he's a face painter.
I had to deal with some guy with red sneakers. He's cheap. He won't take care of his people.
Did he just have a stroke? I don't know what happened.
But what? After seeing the disrespect, I have to say.
Welcome to Middletown.
I have never seen so many ugly people in one spot.
Well, it is a convention. It is a convention, but I mean, thank you.
Extremely rude.
Too many people talking and talking and talking like that one and that one.
What about this guy?
Shut your mouth.
What?
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 I want you to know something. You know. There's a lot of things that have been said about the WWE Hall of Famer, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Woo! Can't touch
there's
this!
Been a lot of things
Wait,
said,
wrong hammer.
But one thing I've never heard anyone say
to you.
Shut up, fat
man!
He's so
fat,
he's got iron shirts in the driveway.
That's me! I ironed my shirt in the driveway! Thank you!
Getting back to Greg Valentine.
Yeah, that dude is way fatter than you.
That Greg the Hammer
he's definitely wearing a diaper. He's
wearing the world's rights of professional wrestling.
Yeah, there was, that Greg the Hammer Valentine match, eventually the bad guy, he turned to me and said, shut up! And I wasn't saying anything at that point. I was just watching in silence because the match was so sad. I don't think anybody threw there was no violence in it at all.
Because they would have broken a hip or something.
It just showcased Greg the Hammer Valentine's bald and kneecaps that you could see his actual kneecaps.
What are you so afraid of? Talking big game, being so afraid of. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it was sad. It was sad. Just like he
but
looked.
The, rest of the show was so great and energetic, and I'm like, I've never been to any wrestling match.
Neither
not like a real like high school wrestling match where people actually think they're Romans.
they don't really think they're Romans. That's not how that works. It's not just like, well, hello, welcome to the arena. Here's Here's your
I'm
chariot.
Thinking of Ridley Scott's Gladiator.
Yes, yes, very different, okay. Very different thing.
Okay, that's. I guess that's why no wrestler in my high school went. This is Washington.
Oh no, they did that too. They just it was for different reasons.
No, I should have went. Watch him kick another scrawny white kid in the chest.
Go back to Monroe Woodbury.
The rest of the night, though, except for that match, was amazing. I wish I would have been following this shit for decades.
Yes.
It was, it's so much fun. I can't wait to go to another
I would
one.
Do this every week. Like, I mean, and to put this in perspective, all right, the tickets were $15. I drove about an hour to get over there, and it was so fucking worth it. It was worth every penny because it was so much fucking fun.
I honestly, like, I didn't expect much. I was excited to go, but pretty much just to see Migs.
Yes.
But, like, I had no idea what I was in for. I did not expect, like, the level of commitment these people had to, like, their quote-unquote characters. Like, the vampire guy bit Andy's neck. Yeah. The prisoner guy looked awesome. It, like, he came out in, like, a, you know, a wrestle-ified...
yeah, like a convict jumpsuit.
Prisoner, like, yeah, and like, the craziest haircut I've ever seen in my life. Yeah. Like, it was a very short mohawk, like, almost like a buzz-cut mohawk, but, like, it went straight down the middle, but it weaved like a snake around the middle of his head. It was gorgeous.
It made no damn sense at all. I love it. There were guys behind us that were, like, yelling stuff out on occasion, too, but, like, not nearly as much. And I remember that...
But I can't remember their jokes. I guess when we hear the audio, maybe we'll call out some jokes on the in a couple episodes. But they had some golden jokes.
I remember one specifically for that one. The guy, he just yelled out, "That hair, though!" And I was like, it's like, well done, man.
Yeah, that was adorable. Before we get to what is clearly the best part of the night, crap, what was I gonna say? I forgot. Shit.
Trying to remember. I know we're missing. There were 8 matches altogether. In
yeah,
thing.
And 7 of them were awesome.
Yeah,
just awesome. Even the Greg the Hammer Valentine match, like the guy he was fighting was great, but they didn't fight because it's clear that Greg the Hammer Valentine cannot do anything
well
anymore.
I don't think that guy could either, because like you saw, I mean, what the funny thing is too, both of them were like just out sitting at a table like an hour before selling pictures and t-shirts. The bad guy was painting kids' faces, like,
yeah,
he had like all face paint on, like the Ultimate Warrior. He was painting kids' faces, and then he came out and screamed at those kids during his match, to be like, "Oh yeah, I don't give a shit."
What did Migs tell us? Like, people, he would come out and meet people's babies and hug them and kiss them, and then he would get into his match and flip the babies off.
He did.
That's an actor. I like that part of it too. I liked, like, they were nice with the fans outside of their match. That was cool. But I like that guy he sold the shit out of his character.
Yeah, he did.
He had like a friggin' 6-minute monologue before the match started.
Yeah.
With 3 minutes was just calling me fat boy. Loved it.
Yeah, this guy insulted you and you're like, yeah, you know, game recognizes game, man. I got you.
Jackie called it out earlier. I was telling her a little bit more about the thing because she reminded me to tell you to send her all of the audio we have. And and she was like, and I was telling her like how people kept insulting me and everything, and eventually they zeroed in on me a lot. And she was like, you know what? I'm sure you had the time of your life because you love attention. And which is somewhat true in events, I love attention. But like, I don't go to movie theaters and like, hey, I have jokes for the whole movie, guys. So let's, just to tell everybody right off the bat, I don't do that in my normal life, but if I'm going to an event where I'm allowed to be loud and obnoxious, I am going to do it the entire time.
And very much encouraged. But there were times, like, at first, I'm like, I didn't realize how fucking loud we were yelling until I'm like, oh, everyone in this entire auditorium fucking heard us because...
Was not yelling.
Yeah, they were not yelling at all, no. So I was like,
We were very good audience members.
Yeah. I would totally do a commentary for it. Like, if they were like, yeah, our regular announcer guy isn't here today. Would you guys do it? Yes.
Of course. We said that a bunch of times.
Yes.
And, like, they film it. And I guess you get, it's put, Keith said it gets put on like cable access or whatever, yeah. something like that. But we couldn't, like, that was one of the things we were missing when we were talking about it. Like, we wanted color commentary yeah. for the match, and there was none of it that we can hear. You thought that it goes specifically to the recorded thing that they air.
Yeah, so they have,
which they really sucks. They need to hook up speakers wherever they are so we can hear that shit.
Yeah.
Because it was sorely missed.
Yes, yeah, especially during the Grab the Hammer Valentine one.
Insulted so much.
Yeah. But, that, but like the
that was louder than
the pitch, like quiet of that of the old person match was just like, because you recognize everyone is uncomfortable by this. Like if you had yeah. any sort of commentary over that instead of just like, let's just all be respectful of how old this guy is for a minute, that would probably play off better.
One of my favorite parts was after intermission, like a match after intermission ended. So I guess match...
like six? Yeah.
Right? There was one lady kind of a... like in also in the front row, but in the section next to us, who had never heard the entire night. Until, like, I'm pretty sure she went and fucking chugged a bottle of Fireball to that. Because she would not stop talking afterwards. And she had the worst, like, I'm a white fat girl who's drunk insults. Like,
yeah, she was, I know who you're talking about, too. Because there was one point, like, she would just yell, and you're like, and I feel like collectively the crowd went, what? And like,
yeah.
We're like really confused for a minute. Like,
and then looked at your brother, you and me. Like, can you say something?
Pull us out of this downward spiral.
Huh?
Pull us out of this downward spiral, please, guys. Help us.
She was just, you know what she is? She's the drunkest girl at a stand-up comedy. That's what she was. Just yelling. Just like, yeah, you have shorts.
Yes.
That was stupid.
Yes. Thank you.
I can do what you do. Hey, you gotta stop. You gotta cool it on the beer hot dogs.
Yeah, so let's talk.
The match of the night.
Match of the night. So
I think we both agree yeah. is the match of the
so
night.
So we went there. The reason why we were
I
there.
I did not expect.
Yes. So the reason why we were there in the first place is guest of the show. Keith Migs, Migliorini, the current champion.
Migliorini, you idiot.
Whatever, close enough. Spaghetti, whatever the fuck his last name is.
Myoglorina.
Yeah.
Keith Myoglorina. Are you here?
Migliravioli is, and you're the one who has a problem with Italians.
No. Not that one. That's the best one. Fuck you, Mike Benizzi. You put on some fucking leotards and fight some really offensive Jewish yeah. stereotype. So,
hold on, you're spoiling it. You're spoiling it, BJ. So let's see. So we got in there because he's the champion now, the ECPW HV champion. So he was defending the title for the first time during this event, and we went to go there. We bought t-shirts. As well, so I fully expect to wear it the next
t-shirt time. I bought immediately got commandeered by Jackie. And then she got mad because I didn't buy her size t-shirt. I also saw the pictures that
yeah, we gotta put those up.
And I realized why I got called fat boy the entire time.
Yeah, I saw that picture
too. I did not look good in that shirt.
No, well, because you put the t-shirt on over, like, you were already wearing, like, a shirt and a flannel shirt on top of it, and then you put
and
it on
hoodie.
Top. Yeah, you just looked strange. You look like a hunchback, so it was just very fucking strange.
Not a good picture. Yeah. I wanted to post it, too, and I was like, I don't know about this one.
Well, no,
I'm still trying to be an actor. Yeah.
Oh, so you're saying I shouldn't put it on the website when we post this episode?
Ah, fuck that. Put it on the website. This is the only thing I'm ever going to be known for. No one listens to it, so.
Because, I mean, even me, like, Keith is the only one that looks like a real human being in that picture. Because, like,
you don't look that bad. You didn't do, like, your Comic-Con weird mannequin shit. You just took a picture this time, which was nice to see. I was hoping, because I zeroed in on myself first, because I'm a narcissist. So I looked at myself. I'm like, well, James probably did something. Oh, fuck, he didn't do anything that looked like a not human being. Oh, God. I look like Patton Oswalt ate Dom DeLuise.
So, yeah, that happened. And but so we'll post that picture on with this episode. The match of the night was, so Keith defended his title for the first time, and I don't even remember who he was supposed to fight against.
Oh, right, his card got changed. He was supposed to fight somebody else. I don't know if they showed up or had a different match, but the guy the guy he beat to win that championship came out, and I was immediately cheering for him. And he, when he walked around and saw me, he was like, fuck you, you got a Migs shirt on. I was like, oh, no. I was trying to be a friend of Puerto Rico. Oh, the guy's name is Reekin Havoc.
Yeah, not offensive at all. But he's
very clever, yeah, but a little offensive.
Yeah. Yeah, so he met the match that the guy he ended up fighting was like, I don't even know what his actual
name was. A guy he talked about, yes, on our episode. He
talked about on our episode.
And I partly didn't believe him that this man existed.
And boy, does he ever. His character name was like Mateus something, but he comes out from quote, Williamsburg, Brooklyn, as a Hasidic Jew with a giant hat. Like a giant, like I don't even know what those things are called. Like the big, weird, circly shaped hat.
It looked like if the Hulk was a bear, it looked like the Hulk's testicles. Like just one
of them.
Big square testicle.
Yeah.
It is enormous. The hat was enormous.
And they did a whole bit where he tries to get into the ring, but he can't because the hat is too big. Then he tosses it to the ref, and it's so heavy it knocks the ref over. Like, it was a whole bit. Now, quick reminder of where we're at, all right? We went to the show in Middletown, New York, in the heart of Orange County, where there is a large Hasidic Jewish population.
Yep.
But the show was on Saturday night, so none of them saw it, certainly, because it's the Sabbath, so none of them saw it. It was
also a Catholic church.
It was also a Catholic church. Yeah, and... And quite, spoiler alert, the guy wasn't actually Jewish. Although, you wouldn't know that based on how often he said, quote, I'm Jewish!
I'm Jewish!
That was...
He did it, like, every move!
Yeah. It was, like, it was so much. Every other thing, he would stop to look to the crowd and be like, I'm Jewish! And we're like, we know! We know. We heard
we
you.
We that's all we could say. We didn't know how to make fun of him. Because he did it himself constantly.
And it was like, this is also really offensive. Like, it's like...
It's incredibly offensive. However, this guy was like the showman of the night.
Yeah. the match was good and everything, and he played it all up. He started, like, with some of the punches, he would shout, like, Menorah! And just fucking punch him.
here's a haymaker now. Let me talk to you about 9 candles.
Well, and I think my brother at one point yelled at him, like, isn't this the Sabbath? And he goes, and he turned to him and yelled, like, oh, yes, but... This is not business. This is pleasure. This is...
This guy did research.
Yeah. He...
To be offensive.
He put work into this. He put some effort into this character.
He put a lot of effort into it. And he took acting classes, I think. Yeah. He was amazing.
It was insane.
Amazing.
And then at one point during the match, Keith pulls out a penny. And it was like, oh, this is going there.
This one made me a little uncomfortable. He throws it to distract the guy. And it worked!
And I do, oh, and as a reminder, like, Keith is the bad guy. He's the heel in all this.
Right.
So, like, he was...
And, like immediately, like, we're rooting for Keith because he's our buddy.
Yeah.
We forgot that he's a bad guy. Yeah.
But I like how he did play it up occasionally too, where he would like yell, he would yell at the ref, or he'd like just like yell out stuff like that. And then there was the bit where they were outside the ring, and he went to slap him. He went to hit the other guy, Mateus, and hit his hand on the pole on the side of the ring. So then the other guy grabs Keith's hand and starts bringing them all around the crowd to go, "Hey everyone, high fives!" And like we all had to like slap Keith's hand as he walked around. It was like, this is great.
It was fun. What kills me? the one of the worst stereotypes I have ever seen was the hero of the he was the good guy.
He's the guy we're supposed to root for.
Nobody rooted for him. But by the end of the match, like, we were all like, "Yeah, you're Jewish."
We know, right?
Matzo balls. My favorite part of the entire night, and the most humanizing aspect of this thing, and what made me realize that these people truly fucking love what they do, and they just want to entertain people. After Keith wins the match, spoilers. Mateus, whatever his name was, he rolls out of the ring right in front of us. And he looks up at Jane, he looks up at you, and goes, "Did you like the match?" And then he goes, "Yeah." And he's like, "It was the best match of the night."
Yeah. Yeah, it was like just like real earnest and everything. And like he could tell like we were into it, we were yelling and everything at the whole thing. And he was like, "Yeah," I was like, "It was good." And it was like, he was like, "Hey man, can you buy my stuff?" I never saw him out there. Plus, I don't think I would be allowed to.
Right. Like I want to support that guy, but like,
yeah, but get it.
Please get it. Be who you are. Yeah. Be as great as you are. But please find a different gimmick. Please. Please.
Yeah, set up a Patreon or
something. Nobody rooted for you, man, and you were the good guy. Yeah. You were in the Hudson Valley. They all hate Jews. Oh. It was incredibly offensive.
Yeah.
Immensely uncomfortable. But I laughed my ass off the whole time. That guy sold everything.
Yeah. Oh, and one thing we didn't mention. So when he rolled out of the ring, like, we did have a moment of panic because there were these, like, metal guardrails set up in between us and the ring. And they just kept falling apart. So, like, anytime someone remotely touched them, like, three guys with zip ties would come out and try to fix it. And they did not do a good job of it. So it would just, like, start to fall apart again. And then
when James says a moment, he means seven moments. This happened so many times. We look, we're like a foot to my left. There was two gates meet in the corner. And we look down and there's a zip tie that's tied, but attached to nothing. It is not holding anything together.
Nope.
It is zip tied around one bar.
Yeah, it was very confusing. But and then,
safety not a concern at ECPW, and that made it even fucking better. Yes.
And my favorite part was when the bad guy in the Greg the Hammer Valentine mask, the Metal Maniac, he went to like yell at the kids after the match who were yelling at him, and he grabbed the guardrail, and the whole thing just by him touching it. The whole thing just fell apart, and he looked around and he's like, "What the hell's going on around here?"
Yeah, he said, he commented on it. I remember the first time it happened, we thanked the crew who came and fixed it, and then like maybe 10 minutes later it happened again, and we just stared at the crew disapprovingly.
You're not part of a union, are you?
No. In a union of any sort in that place.
Yeah.
But best damn live show I've ever been to.
It was so good.
Fuck you, Louis C.K. ECPW is where it's at.
Yeah, if you get a chance to see it, by all means, do make the effort to see it because it is well worth it. It was so much fun. I fully intend to do it again.
Crazy fun.
I cannot wait to do it again.
They're so great. audience. If you're a good, if you're a boisterous audience member, they will play right with you.
Yeah.
They're amazing. They're all, these guys are fucking phenomenal. Oh, my, you know what made me a little sadder than Greg the Valentine?
I don't know. The Holocaust? I can't think of anything else that would be sadder than that match.
No, I'm all right with that.
Yeah.
Well, it made me sad. I'm not all right with the Holocaust. Remember the dude, I think his name was Mike Iannuzzi. Remember we kept chanting, Iannuzzi! That was just me. Yeah. Again, and the audience was never behind me.
No, was that the guy in the orange?
Yeah, we were sitting next to his dad.
Yes.
Corey was next to his dad.
Yes.
And after that match ended, the dad stands up, collects his family, and what did he say to you? I've seen all I came here to see.
Yes, that's what it was. I
fucking left. Without saying goodbye to his son, he collected his family, left the building. Fuck you, Mike Iannuzzi's dad. Mike Iannuzzi, you're a wonderful athlete. Fuck your dad. What an asshole. Your dad's an asshole. He should be proud of you.
I don't think that he meant it that, like, well, I can leave my son here forever. He can, like, I'm sure that, like, if the kid still
right,
lives at
son
home.
Right, his son was an adult, but, like, he just left. He just got up immediately after pinfall and split.
Yeah.
And made it a point to tell us, I came here what I had to see and split. Fuck you. Great show. Thank you very much to Keith Migliorini.
Is that, oh, that's how you say it? All right.
Yes, you've known this guy for 20 years.
Yeah, I know lots of people. It doesn't mean I know how to say all their words and their names.
How do you spell my name? How do you spell my name?
Boothie, right? That's your last name?
My social studies teacher in 10th grade called me Boothie. He didn't know how to say it. When I corrected him, finally, he still refused to say it correctly. He didn't call me BJ at that point anymore. He just called me Boothie all the time. You're a piece of shit,
yep,
James.
Yeah, I know.
We got to talk about Thor.
You gotta talk about Thor. So that's
we have 18 minutes left.
Yeah, we got plenty of time. Don't worry about it. Again, if you get a chance to see it, Do go to one of these shows because
crazy fun, very affordable, and super worth it.
Yeah.
Let me know how the sauerkraut tastes because it's not offered to me.
All right, so Thor 3 came out. Thor Ragnarok came out. All right, so on that note, usual wrap up things here, folks. If you want to send us anything? Send us. If you want to tell us your experiences with ECPWHV, send us a note, RagingNerdOn@gmail.com or @RagingNerdOnPod on Twitter. Otherwise, the usual nonsense, iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play is where you can find the show if you found it somehow, so hopefully you could just keep doing that over and over again every time we release an episode. But if you subscribe to it, it just does it for you. Do that. That's easier. And if you do that and you like it, maybe leave a positive review over on iTunes. That would be great, or on any of these platforms. But that's it then, folks, for this episode of Raging Nerd On. I have been James Ferguson.
I'm a little fat boy who sucked James off in the bathroom at an independent wrestling event.
You didn't have to air out all of our secrets, even though that guy figured it out. He did call us Bob
and Neil. That guy aired out all of our secrets.
That's true.
And I'm sure it's on the recording that they filmed.
Yep. Nerd on, everybody.
It's on the recording that they filmed. If they air the Neil and Bob joke on public access.
Yes, and here it is. The bad guy is coming in here. And, yep, and he's doing his usual roundup of the crowd. And he just called those two white boys
gaylords.
Yep, welcome to the show, everybody. Those two fags are in the front row.
Come off of his lips. It might be sauerkraut, but I'm not going to look into it.
We've had unsubstantiated reports of wild sauerkraut in the audience. There is wild sauerkraut in the crowd. So be careful, folks. Be careful out there. I don't know where I was going with that.
Super effective. I don't know.
super effective.
All I can think of for wild sauerkraut is what it was. It was super effective. Just end this episode.
Is that a Pokemon reference?
I didn't think it through. It's the end of the episode. I have to pee. Yeah. I pooped before this episode, but I gotta think I gotta do it again. Are we recording still?
Good night, I guess. You didn't have to tell me, like, I'm gonna go poop now. Boom, boom. Okay.
I was gonna text it to you anyway.
Yeah. So guess where I am? I'm in the bathroom.
Just stop recording.
I'm in the bathroom, just like that guy said I was, but now I'm by myself and I'm pooping.
I hate you so much.
This is so going in the episode.
I know. I don't understand why this is the thing I'm embarrassed about. Just so many... too many gay jokes, too many racist jokes, but now I don't want the audience to know I pooped. Okay.
I gotta rethink my fucking life. I was fine with all that other stuff, but the moment I found out that the fat one pooped, no. Ew.
Yeah.
Ew. That's where I draw the line.
I'm Jewish!
Well, Mazel Tov.
You too.
Good night, sir.
Bye.